So the next song, we might as well quickly move on. The next song that we are going to be talking about is going to be in position number 3 for us. And that is going to be Ireland. And Ireland will be represented by Lesley Roy, who has been on this podcast and she has spoken to us. She's given us so much love as well. And shout out to Lesley. And yeah, she will be singing her song Maps. And if you haven't heard Maps, then here is a clip of it.
I really, really like Maps. I think it's one of Ireland's best entries in maybe the last decade. I think Ireland have had this issue where a lot of people have found their songs generic and said their songs don't really stand out. However, I think this does, and I think, like, you can tell that this song is very personal to Lesley and it means a lot to Lesley, and I really, really like that. I can see her giving quite the live performance. I feel like this will be quite an impassioned performance. I could see some very interesting staging with this because it's all about like her journey back home. Like there's so many like chances for staging. I do think there's been times where Ireland, when it comes to staging for Ireland, they often hit the nail on the head. They get the staging absolutely right. We saw this in 2018 where we thought, nah, this song ain't gonna do anything, and then the staging came along and it did pretty well. It came 16th, which was Ireland's best result in years. So we know Ireland can stage songs well. I think there's a lot of like support behind Lesley, like from the Irish community. I feel like within the Eurovision fandom, I definitely see that the RTE wanted to put quite a lot behind her and giving her that good station that can push her into the final. So, yeah. As for my prediction, I could see this finishing around maybe 7th or 8th in the semi, and that's just simply because it's a strong semi. It's not because I think that Maps is a bad song. I just think this semi is really strong and there's a lot of contenders. I would personally hope it would finish a little bit higher than that, but we know in the past Ireland have often struggled, so I feel like a prediction of around 7th or 8th in the semi is probably fair for it. But I can definitely see Ireland being back in the final, so that's a good thing.
I'm just going to be straight up on this. It's my number one. I love this song so much. I think it feels like this song was just written for me. It has everything I love in a piece of music. It's got that sort of that powerful bass. It's got violins and drums. It's got beautiful lyrics. It's got a fantastic singer and it's empowering and it's powerful and it makes me smile and it makes me happy, but it's not shallow or vapid or just sort of surface level. I think it is just a wonderful piece of music and I've not stopped listening to it since it came out. It fills me with joy and I really want this to do well. It is so, so deserved. And I know there are people who think it's a borderline qualifier. I am going to be gutted if this does not qualify. I think it deserves a place in the final. And I also think it will do quite well in the final because a lot of countries who traditionally would vote for Irish entries are voting in semi two, the UK being one of them. So I think if it can get through that semi and it can get to the final, I think it stands a chance of doing very well. And I hope it does. So yeah, I would like to sort of echo Jazzy's prediction. I think it could be about sort of 5th to 8th in the semi, get through to the final, and then I imagine hopefully a top 15 result. But I love it so much. It just makes me so happy.
Yeah, I love Maps. I think it's so full of energy and it's so full of passion as well. And that's kind of something that we've been sort of missing in Ireland's entries recently. you know, we've had songs like 22, we've had songs like Together, we've had Dying to Try, we've had Sunlight. You know, these are all good songs, but they've just not had any sort of oomph for them. And then Maps and Story of My Life come along and completely change the game. And I totally understand why so many people love Lesley Roy. She is an amazing woman. Her voice is so like unique. It's so distinctive, really. And this song just does it Ireland so much justice. And coming from Ireland, obviously, you know, we have a bit of a reputation. You know, we have 7 wins. We're looking for the 8th win, all that kind of stuff. And I think this is just something that Ireland should really, really be proud of. And, you know, I've seen so many people, especially within the Irish Eurovision community on Twitter and on Facebook as well, pushing radio stations to be putting this on mass rotation. Last time I had seen, Maps was actually number 3 in the Irish charts. So it's fantastic to see that Ireland is actually really getting behind Lesley. I really hope that come to Rotterdam, she will be able to smash it out of the park live. We have seen, you know, some questionable songs, like performances from her before, obviously from the Late Late Show in 2020, but obviously there were some mic problems with that. I'm just really hoping that it's going to do well. I think it will qualify. I'm thinking between 6th and 7th, and then maybe once we get into the final, I'm hoping maybe 14th. I'm not expecting it to win, which is a shame, but it's still going to be a fantastic representation of Ireland. And I just like the sound of this, and I'm really looking forward just to seeing how they're going to stage it. Is she just going to be running around the whole stage? I hope. I'm really looking forward to seeing it.